both said, how many agree and how many didn't agree and so on. But she talked about the need for an integrated service, and she talked about rural demography. So, and she also went on to talk about community ownership.
Yeah, sure.
So, the question that we need to look at is, how does, if the Cabinet comes up with a view, how we get from that view to the public, and when we get the feel on probably the same about the 24 hours or whatever it might be, then how do you respond? So if the Cabinet says, well, we've got the figure and that's your loss, or if the public came back and said, sorry, in our particular community, we don't think that's good enough. And the constituency committee might not have the funding to try and implement it. So I'm trying to see how the process would actually work.
I can't. I think just to recap, there was absolute agreement that what was put forward wasn't acceptable. What we all did, we and we discussed it around, it was a good discussion, and I've been a bit remiss, I should thank him as I said to Professor Okay. Was that we thought it was a good and wise thing to pass back to community libraries. Their ownership of their own families and to let them decide how best to fit their community. And put that, give that to each individual constituency committee to work with. I think with regards to what else you just said, I understand what you're asking about, I can't answer it, but at this point in time we're not decision making, we're just gonna agree to refer us to Cabinet to look that again.
Using the council's strong also one of the things I'm concerned about is when we talk about going back to communities and asking them, you know, is that how are we going to use these hours? Are we going to really, I mean, it's only an application, but how are we going to use these hours in the library? It's making sure that we really get the distribution of the local community rather than library staff. We did discuss that, but that again is down to us as councillors and local community groups to get that feedback. And Tanner, to answer some of the concerns, is if there's not enough hours, then we've got to go back and say, well, how do we fill that need then? Whether it's through volunteers or groups, if we feel the need for more hours or more involvement or a better resource in the area, that's where we need to come back and consider what we do.
Yeah, I just asked that, which certainly aren't site planning challenges, maps, streets away. I mean, on the night, we did have a slight different opinion on who would be best to ask with regards to moving out, some suggestions of employees, some suggestions on library users, so that was a point of the discussion. Tom, you want to think about it?
Yeah,
specifically, but there are everyone who does not have any
advertising tonight, and I've read, I think it's an excellent piece of task and finish this by the subcommittee that did it from all the parties. But it seems to me, as a deputy, this authority is trying its utmost to maintain all 24 libraries in the borough. And I think it's evident to me, I and my colleague Phil Bragmore, we work extensively with the Friends Group in Pensley Library, who are very active. And I'm not surprised about the petition that's coming from there. So they are a very active group. We've been working from day one with them in these dark days, and they are dark days, and this council is changing. And we've got to realise this for the reasons which are clearly obvious to me. But with regard to the libraries, we are trying our utmost to maintain the 24 libraries, from the cabinet member right down to us members working on the ground. I think there's been some excellent options there in this task force. I actually think each library is an individual and separate unity with its own needs, its wants, and its usage. So we have to take that into regard. I think this is an excellent vehicle that the constituency forums can now play a big part, along with the Friends groups. But as Paul said, the basic problem is the areas of most need are the underused libraries, and I wouldn't be surprised if they're the libraries where there's no Friends groups. So I just want to add that as a supplement to what Paul said, Chair. Thank you.
Thanks, Matt. Bill?
Thank you. Thank you, Chair. I think there's this, the members of the Task and Finish Group, as is right, we said, reeled away from the vacation, what we've done to do, but we looked at the cliff and said we're not having that. We tried to find a way forward, so I think cross-party that was done. We did have, I think, about 60 pages when I looked at it again, of documentation giving us a portrait of each library, because that's what we saw. We're not delving into more detail, because when I say looking at sort of a problem, which is go down from 40 to perhaps 34, then you look at where the uses of people coming in, the number of people coming in. Our books issued between 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock, and I was looking at figures from January on 30s when there's 24, 35 and 17 in 3 weeks in January last year. So there clearly are people going to the library and taking books out times, and we don't necessarily measure any issues. Earlier I mentioned charter support, so forgive me if we're making a recommendation to cabinet, could I suggest something that might help if members like it, they can say so if they don't know how we have. But can I suggest that in addition to the conclusions of the panel, the cabinet is reminded of the findings of Sue Charteris with regard to the need for an assessment of local needs, the requirements of children, the need for a strategic plan, and the requirement to address the needs of deprived communities, and be asked to develop a process to ensure that this is taken into account.
Thanks, Bill. I don't see a problem with that.
In 2012, when it produced an additional 75 budget is the first reduction, reducing 5% as a figure that was allowed, but only allowing it to Band 80D. You'll see that we have one of only two authorities that still have this, where Wallasey is already committed to reducing this over a number of years to move their scheme actually from small yards originally, but it's now being reduced. The discount, as it says, is not being tested, and those on lowest income receive council tax support, and therefore have to pay no or a proportion of council tax. The proposal before you is a saving of £600,000, but it does now cease 5% of all and on all bands of the main gates D's. It is a local discretionary scheme, therefore that will form part of the annual council tax awards that will be done in March. We approved actually in early March, we have to give 28 days notice. It is not something that is set that we have to give 12 months notice in some of the other areas we deal with. This is a 28 day notice, but this is obviously for yourself to consider and make recommendations to cabinet with some supportive information and impacts for the then following report.
Thank you. Just again, I'd like to thank
thank you.
did agree with them that there isn't any budget proposal that don't have some people with a disadvantage by it. And to put it in by the context of what the people are having to pay extra on to the less incomes. But I do take the point, and we did look at that and we must.
It's through you, Chair. And again, this decision was taken forward in the fifth observation was to then look at ways of trying to alert people with just the vulnerable levels therefore most likely to feel the impact of the withdrawal of the pension discount to see if we can point them towards other assistance, whether or not they would then qualify for some level of council tax support potentially they haven't previously applied for. The actual box on page 17 does actually show the amounts of council tax people income eligibility that would actually be trying to give some kind of assessment as to how much this impact would be, showing how much people would be worse off in a week if they lost all of it and there was no mitigation in council tax support. So trying to show yes there is an impact, how much that would be per week, but it will be certainly the task of ministry but clear that they would expect us as officers to try and do things within the building regime to try and alert people who may be able to apply for things so at least make that application.
I've not been notified of any of the business. So thank you everyone.